Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of James. Not many of you should become teachers, my brothers and sisters, for you know that we who teach will be judged with greater strictness, for all of us make many mistakes. Anyone who makes no mistakes in speaking is perfect, able to keep the whole body in check with a bridle. If we put bits into the mouths of horses to make them obey us, we guide their whole bodies. Or look at ships, though they are so large that it takes strong winds to drive them, yet they are guided by a very small rudder, wherever the will of the pilot directs. So also the tongue is a small member, yet it boasts of great exploits. How great a forest is set ablaze by a small fire, and the tongue is a fire. The tongue is placed among our members as a world of iniquity. It stains the whole body, sets on fire the cycle of nature, and is itself set on fire by hell. For every species of beast and bird, of reptile and sea creature, can be tamed and has been tamed by the human species. But no one can tame the tongue, a restless evil, full of deadly poison. With it we bless the Lord and Father, and with it we curse those who are made in the likeness of God. From the same mouth come blessing and cursing. My brothers and sisters, this not ought to be so. Does a spring pour forth from the same opening both fresh and brackish water? Can a fig tree, my brothers and sisters, yield olives, or a grapevine figs? No more can salt water yield fresh. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I cry to the day of 135, take up my cross.
Thank you.
Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus went on with his disciples to the villages of Caesarea Philippi. And on the way he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that I am?" And they answered him, "John the Baptist, and others Elijah, and still others one of the prophets." And he asked them, "But who do you say that I am?" Peter answered him, "You are the Messiah." He sternly ordered them not to tell anyone about him. Then he began to teach them that the Son of Man must undergo great suffering and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and after 3 days rise again. He said all this quite openly, and Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. But turning and looking at his disciples, he rebuked Peter and said, "Get behind me, Satan, for you are setting your mind not on divine things, but on human things." And he called a crowd of his disciples and said to them, "If anyone wants to become my disciples, let them deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For those who want to save their life will lose it, and those who lose their life for my sake and for the sake of the gospel will save it. For what will it profit them to gain the whole world and forfeit their life? Indeed, what can they give in return for their life? Those who are ashamed of me and of my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, of them the Son of Man will also be ashamed when he comes in the glory of his Father and with the holy angels." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Went straight despite the best efforts to trace it. For whatever reason, he didn't want to be traced, he didn't want to be recognised. But he'd done his job. He'd done what was necessary. He'd seen people in danger, and he'd made a phone call. Because of that, some brave people came out and rescued them. And these are some lyrics from the song that's composed by Martin Joseph Hartley here by Murphy. You can walk out in heaven and end up in hell. And when all hope is gone, when we call, somehow it survives. Some say there's angels in heaven, but sometimes we need them down right here on earth. Some days they're in surfboards and then disappear, but not before they've made some phone calls when they've seen us wave and set out to save us, selfless and brave. A perfect setting and a beautiful day, Chapel Forth Beach and the Atlantic Sea could have taken two lives, but a lifeboat gave back three. Of course, she came once pregnant, and then she'd gone on to have three children. Now, I find that such an inspirational story because that's all our faith is. That's all our faith is, just to be rescued, just to sometimes cry out for help, and then just let Jesus come and rescue us. That's it. Everything else just follows on from that. We don't need to do anything. Jesus has done it all for us. We just need to accept the rescue that Jesus has done. Jesus says, "Who do people say that I am?" Well, he's the one that comes to save us. He's the one that paddles on those paddle boats. He's the one that brings that lifeboat for us. And he's the one that where the world could take so much from us, he gives us back that life that God has promised to us. And sometimes we are called on to do something in our world. Sometimes we are called on to be angels. Sometimes we're called on to be lifeboats ourselves, to those around us, to give people the help that they might need. And sometimes that the job of an angel, that is why the song says sometimes we need angels here, is to give a message. And sometimes that's our calling too. But it's only as a result of what God's already done for us. And this has shown me very clearly this week when I watched Field of Dreams. Field of Dreams, not the Kevin Costner film, but the series about young cricketers trained by Freddie Flintoff. Has anyone seen this? When you watch it, it's absolutely marvellous. It's absolutely fantastic. Now, I would not, before I watched this programme, ever have described Freddie Flintoff as an angel, okay, let alone a lifeboat. But it seems that he is. Because in the first series, he oppressed the lad himself, as I'm sure you know, took at Preston Cricket Club some young lads who, and this was amazing to me, they don't teach cricket in schools anymore. Did you know that?
No.
I didn't. I just thought it was a normal thing, but they don't. And as a result of this, people who play cricket at the top level are mostly from private schools, and very few ordinary boys or girls get to play at that kind of league level because they've never been taught it. So what he did is to set up a cricket class at Preston Cricket Club. This was 2 years ago, before his accident, and taught ordinary working class lads, it was all lads, and basically just taught them how to play cricket. And it was a thing. Now, I'm not a good cricketer by any means, okay? But I just, because I was taught at school, I know how to bowl a ball. These lads, when they got the ball, their idea of bowling was to literally chuck the ball at the wicket. Okay? They've never been shown. dealing also with all the kind of personal issues, because they deliberately targeted young men from very difficult backgrounds and all the issues that went along with that. And one of them, he shows up in a conversation with him, and this young lad lives less than half a mile away from this church. Okay? And he said, well, I buy some flowers here. And he said, well, why are you not confused? He said, well, I like going out to the park on the night. And he said, well, what do you do? And he said, well, I drink two bottles of vodka. Whether he does or not. But that was actually his attitude to life. But from this experience of being shown that life is more than that and life has more to offer than that, the second series shows this team being taken to Kolkata in India, Calcutta, which has a special resonance for me because that's exactly where I went in what would be called now my gap year between school and university. And it shows these young men transform from being kind of aimless, directionless, despairing life into quite a good cricket team, going to Calcutta and experiencing something that they could never have imagined. And it shows them playing cricket in the park against teams that have in Calcutta played from being very small age and being very good at it. And I recognise that park, and I recognise the Victoria Monument in the background, because that's exactly where I'd been. And when I was there, I'd had him football in that park with some young people who invited us over. And the team played against an elite girls' side, okay, who had been selected and were actually a very, very good cricketing side. And it shows them, and it goes through the match, and eventually, well, I'm not spoiling it, but it comes to a cliffhanger. But the point is, they could give them a match. So they've been transformed from people who've never played cricket, but more than that, never had really any expectation or hope in life, to a group of young people who were focused and who realised they could do something that they never thought they would be able to do before. And it shows, in one of the series, this young man who lives less than half a mile up here was put in charge of the team, captained it. And it showed that he'd gone from this kind of this aimless young kid who had nothing in life to being passionate, captain, shouting encouragement, giving advice, enthusing his own team to do something. And his life had been transformed. That's what the job of an angel is, isn't it? That's what the job of an angel is. And it shows Fred from the lecture when he said, here's what you can do this. But by trying your best and doing something, it shows that you were able to do it. Well, that's true for the rest of your life as well, not just for cricket. Try and do something and you'll achieve it. So it shows life transformed. So that's all God wants us to do. To accept the rescue that comes in several different forms, whether on surfboards or whether in cricket coaches, or whatever it is, to accept the rescue that will be there for us. And sometimes ourselves to work with God, sometimes to be angels, sometimes to be like God. So let us stand and declare our faith in God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father.
right hand of the Father.
He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead,
and his kingdom will have no end.
We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life,
who proceeds from the Father and the Son,
who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified,
who has spoken through the prophets.
We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic Church.
We acknowledge all baptism for the forgiveness of sins.
We look for the resurrection of the dead
and the life of the world to come.
Amen.
Let us pray. Let us pray to the Father, who has called us to follow Christ in all things. Fill, O Lord, your church with wisdom, that it may reflect your love and light, and be an image of your goodness. Give us courage to face the hard demands of the gospel, never afraid to confess Christ our Saviour, not just in what we say, but in the way that we live. Give wisdom to all who preach and teach. Help us to avoid careless and hurtful words. Guide us toward unity with all who profess your name. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Bless with your wisdom all places of learning. We pray for our schools, colleges, and universities. We pray for all students having to make decisions about their future. We bring before you those who are coming to study here, that they might feel welcomed, secure, and find friendships that last. We pray for all who have influence through speaking and writing, that they may always promote truth. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for all who live and work here, for families and those who provide our day-to-day needs, for those who serve us unseen around the clock. We pray for your blessing on our community food market, our volunteers, and those whom we welcome. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, support those who are fearful and anxious. We remember all who are lonely and desperate. We pray for the suicidal and those who are always ready to befriend and listen to them. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We give you praise with your saints in glory, all who have confessed the faith and are in your kingdom. We pray for all who have departed this life, especially Dave Wade, whose funeral is to be held later this week, and the boys killed in the car crash on the docks. Be with all who mourn them. Lord, in your mercy. We bring all our prayers to you through St. Michael, St. Mark, and your saints. Merciful Father,
I take these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Our Saviour Christ is the Prince of Peace. The increase of his peace and his government there shall be no end. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Help one another, a sign of peace.
Thank you.
Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit he took flesh. As your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death, but dying for us, and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name and praising you and singing. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith. Sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of Michael and Mark and of all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. So as one church family in Christ, we pray as our Saviour taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power and glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share with the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one breath. Now, if you notice sheep, let's say together our post-communion prayer. God our bishop, who alone brings growth to your church, send your Holy Spirit to give vision to our planning, wisdom to our actions, and power to our witness. Help our church to grow in numbers, its spiritual commitment to you, and in service to our local communities. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Father, Lord, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, you heard your love, gave us grace, and opened the gate to glory. May we, who share Christ's body, live his risen life. We who drink his cup, bring life to us. We who the Spirit lights, give light to the world. Keep us served in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be great, and the whole earth will live to praise your name, through Christ our Lord. Well, now this looks very interesting. This cross that's been brought here, somebody got to come and explain what you've done in Judea Church. Why you've brought this very large cross to the front of the church. Don't talk for one.
Thank you.
God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be amongst you, with all that you hold in your hearts, this day and evermore.